pass, men were known by their deeds, not by a color. Because many people have lost the strength to do the deeds of God. You have to organize a system of oppression to begin to ordain men and give them pastors and make them what? Pastors of me. Even why they wanted to choose deacons, they gave a criteria that only God can do to a man, not that we men can do. So now, we have men that went to Bible schools. And they gave them color. So by their color now, we know that this is a reverend. This is very reverend. This is a pastor. Why? By their color. Not by their deed. We always say that in Lafayette, maybe one day we will storm many of those places where they, you know, in our Orthodox church there is a meeting where only the elders do. And elders sit upon high places. But we don't do those churches before. Elders sit on high. So you are watching the elders from that side. That's what I'm saying. They will tell you, go out fast. They will go and take the Vita. I get what I'm saying. They are like the Pharisees. They tell you what to do, they don't do it. They know what is supposed for you to do. I get what I'm saying, but they will not do it. So we intend one day, we'll gather the youth. We'll give one cutlass, we'll give one stick. Give the other one along. Who bring crippled, blind, deaf, dumb. We gather the elders. And we close the gate. Shall you have color? Okay. According to the characteristics here. And when anyone is in, we should call for the elders. Elders, your elder will look upon you. Use, position yourself. Come, I'm elder. Tell the doctor. If you don't put that name, they will fight you. Tell the doctor. Archbishop. Hear the blind man. There is no camera for this one now. Nobody will know whether you build or not. There are sticks, there are rods, there are cutlass. I say in that past, many were known by their deeds. You can't call yourself an apostle if there are no deeds. The words will speak for you at the gate. You can't say you are a prophet. It's a hard thing to be a prophet. You can die tomorrow. They need to kill some of them and eat. When there was famine, the prophet was hiding. They went and looked for Elijah. The king went and said, "Oh man, people are dying. What are you doing here? I pray to his God." If you don't change the situation tomorrow, your meat will be the one that will be eaten in the market square. That was when the prophet said, "By this time tomorrow, we have to pray to God, so that the captivity can be changed." Why? Because these guys are not joking. They came with cutlass. The elders are the last hope of our generation. But if the elders do not do their duty, God will have to bypass what? Protocol. Let's gather the youth. Baba, heal the blind. If Baba refuses to pray, the youth will flood in. Then we hit him with the law. Are you an elder?
color do you relate? How did you get the color?
He himself will run away and say, I am not a pastor. My name is, for I'm not God. I don't even have a name. Better doctor. Pray for the people. He refused. Power. From that time, if they say, can you go and be the reverend of this church? He went away. Why? There are no deeds.
In that past, men were known by their deeds, not by their color. Now they are known by their color. Now there are forums of archbishop. There are forums of doctors, very reverend doctors.
Say, Charlie, we need to yet again revisit one why those things were established. And if you are not qualified to take it away. You must understand that God has by far the protocol of this crisis. We have looked upon them for a very long time. Now they can't help us. So God began to read the unprecedented situations where people are needed to be improved. Went beyond the protocol and they reached out to you. The reason why you are perceiving the strong hand of God as operational in your life is simply because there are no longer elders. There are no longer two voices. So God has to reach out begin to finally come this system. To begin to raise a remnant again. Who is your brother? The elders are supposed to be our last line defense as porters. But they are not again. Warn us when terrible times are coming. We now just realize suddenly that the potters have lost their place. I always say that every house or every region has worth men. God has apportioned worth men. Their job description is supposed and ensure that they watch over the territory. And let there be no encroachment. Let the devil know God thus far. The doctor and that go are no more further. Don't pass. This is my jurisdiction of watch. But the watchmen have lost their place. The watchmen have slept. As the wise men slept, the enemy came and did this. When they slept, the enemy came. Give some of them color. I was at an ordination party, the one to ordain the man is sleeping that day. Without a fact. I have been to God. It's your ordination. You are supposed to breathe the spirit. Last in tongues for like 30 hours. So that the person that wants to ordain you will be not qualified. As he tried to put the color, he will fall. They spoke about in Daosa. In Daosa was at God in this school of ministry. Every day they teach how Africans are dying. How there are witchcraft in Africa. How there are witches and wizards. They forgot that their land is to live with darkness. But they focus on Africa. Daosa will keep crying, oh God. And I am here. One day, he went and said, see, I can no longer graduate. Graduate me now. I want to return back home. I cannot be here. Africans are dying. You have to sit down together and convocate Bobby in Daosa and send him back to Africa. Why in Daosa landed with him? as he landed, everybody that come to shake him was under that anointing. Why? The guy had his whole hand clean. Now he began to move everywhere looking for the witches and the loser. The darkness in Africa should go. He was not known by a brother, he was known by his deed. The truth is this: if you continue to embrace the color, it is let it be. Stop. There's going to be a heavy decadence that will come upon the body of Christ. There are men that are known by their deed. There are few. If you gather color men in Nigeria, they have let you. By the color, please. Huh? You are known by your deed. There was a time just some weeks ago I was at home. I'm here to be ordained. Huh? I don't know where they will ordain me because I'm not qualified. Our archbishop and bearer they look at us and say, go to Bible school. When you finish this year, we will ordain you. The reverend. I say, sir, I'm not interested. Say, we know you have power. We know you know God. But you are not ordained. How can we accept you? I say, God don't call men. Well, men don't call men. God call men. Yes. Who truly ordained graces? Who ordained apostles? Who ordained prophets? Who ordained teachers? You are not qualified to ordain me, sir. Your ordination is useless if God did not ordain me. Yes. You can ordain me anything. If God did not ordain me, I will suffer. Yes. I will die a painful death. Yes. I say, sir, keep your ordination. My daughter could not sleep. This thing happened. This one is dying. This one, I said, don't you have reverence? Don't you have elders in yourself? Don't you have pastors? I'm not ordained. The location of God is known. It's not by the color. An imam can wear color. I don't know God. They call me. Apostle to my sister as grandma. I say, what's the degree of your mad? That is, she's really mad. You know, insanity has degree. Oh my God, it's that for when your brain is confused. Before you start laughing. Before then, you start up and down. Then you change the way you put clothes. Then you start eating from Thursday. Then you start walking naked. That is the highest dimension. And you sleep outside. Your sister is mad. Where did this start? Just yesterday. Where is she? She's running up and down. Don't you go up in your church? Say, we talk to them and them say, go, she's okay. Ay. Carry kopoko. Carry cutlass. Reverend. I have been in this church for a very long time. Yeah, big time, yeah. High people, we're not saying call upon the other. Reverend was afraid. I was in a deliverance with the Reverend. I wanted to lay hands. He said, no, don't try it. This spirit can come upon you. I look at the man again. Oh God, what a waste. One say you have to divorce his wife. Why? She's a witch. I am Reverend. Cast out the witch and enjoy your wife. Another one said, every time they are praying, the wife keep manifesting. I said, that's good, that's your practical. You don't understand what I'm saying? Men are known by their deeds, not by their color. What God does that his wife can never put for him again. Why? Because he believes that she is. That you see her at night coming to attack him. Sorry, with all due respect, you have to use that one. With all due respect, sir. How long have you been in ministry? Sir, go back home. Love your wife. See, let me tell you. If there are no deeds that God is working with you, ask yourself the question. Are you sure you know God? I'm not joking. Show me your faith without works, I will show you my works by my faith. My sister is mad. She ran up and down. I said, okay. Simple prayer. And mind you, sometimes when you pray for a madman, the madness can increase to the highest dimension and return back to zero. If you have faith. Simple prayer. So I'm talking to you now, it's okay. They have not given me color yet. I'm not qualified. If it is talking about Baba Dada, whether they should allow him to be part of the pastor's CAC or something like that there. And they were discussing, and they were saying miracles are finished, all those things are finished, this one has finished. Suddenly a madman carrying contact for seeing everybody, even plus the reverend. That was when Baba Dada went straight. He left their meeting. He went straight to the madman and said, forget it for that. You are not mad now. And that day they canceled the discussion again. That day they say you can become anything you want to be. No need for the ordination. Your deed has proven for you. People criticize me a lot until one day. One of the pastors, his wife was to give birth and she's in CS. The child is, instead of like this, the child is like this in the stomach. Push! It's a waste of time. And now remember there is one guy that has to go that he knew God. With he has to humble himself. They say it's waiting. I said, let him wait the more. Let him wait the more. Simple prayer. Tight on. How God will give the righteous sometimes is by their deed of faith. I'm telling you. Seriously. Someone is praying, fight us. All these prayers we are praying too much. What kind of prayer? That day, what kind of prayer is there? What are you going to do? How big is your sin? You are wicked. You want to kiss him like? I said, mommy, you need to have an energy. If you don't challenge it to prayer, they will use it and do all kinds of things. Until one day their son could not breathe well. And now remember there are people that pray. The son came to me crying, I can't breathe. I said, hey, this is beyond us, we can't breathe. It's a demon. Just simple pressure of hand. The demons skip like ram and fly. And I saw the boy began to blast the dogs in my room. I was shocked and surprised as I'm talking to you now. Everything diagnosed, all those they are, I can't even read those their writings that they diagnosed. It's beginning history. And boy, you go to school, anyway, to meet you go and pray 3 hours. He will send me a text. Because I'm trying to meet, I cannot meet, I'm praying. I say, continue to pray. You have been reading for a very long time, that's why I continue to pray. Continue to pray. He said, is that the way? He said, no, I said, continue to pray. Still have time. Still have time. There has to be some deed of your faith. I just want to say. Lady met me, she said she has been a Catholic for a very long time. She saw me pray that she just like the way I pray. She saw power demonstrated. If I demonstrate power now today, you will enjoy it, you will like it. That's my detox. What about you? If I prophesy now, you will like it. What about you? You see why nobody admire you? You know what I'm saying? They invited me to carry talk. I saw the baby there. I saw a man standing on top of a snake. I don't know how they put that in there. God help me, God, it's a record. You know about me. I do like it too. But when it was time, power flew. All kinds of things happened. I was invited with a father. The father came and he was pressing water on people. Once I came, I did not plan with, I didn't come with water. Then there was the water they used to hide inside. They press it. Or you don't know it. Or they will do. I came with a sword in the spirit. When I came, I began to charge. I charged, I charged. I charged, I charged. You have to see a change. When things begin to invade the home, everybody was confused. Father was looking for how to go out. I said, close the door. And they who? He said, hey, Mamua. He said, now is the time of God. When I began to cry, angels were moving up and down. And before you know it, men everywhere scattered. Father came to me later. And he began to read it. I said, it's a privilege to you, sir. I appreciate what you people do. I like the Saturday confession every day, every week. He says there is a greater man. You understand which of what I can do. Father, many of them come and meet me. How did you do this? He says it's nothing, it's just a walking with God. When you know God, when you cry, God will call. Forget that teaching and talking with you like this. If I who are, God will come. Why? He has become his ever time when you are not here. When you are here, it's more easier. The expectation will provoke God to come. I go to place where nobody speaking tongues. I sing all the songs I know nobody follow me in the background. They were like dead men. One I began to cry. Support system from heaven came. The place began to sound and to sing. Men began to skip like her. Demons began to fly out. When you go to play, when people don't know God, God will make you more anointed. Yes, sir. If you don't know God, say, Tadim. Yes. I know the verse to press in the spirit. Open the mountain of the river of life. It's not talking. I'm telling you. We will cry today. God will show. See, how do you do this thing? See, let me tell you. Jesus did all kinds of things. They do not believe in the Messiah. In fact, I believe he said I am the Messiah too soon. But why he began to do many things? Because he was came at night, he said, see, we know. We know that you are the Christ. Because no man who has these things. So we have discussed, not that I know, we have discussed among our people. We know that thou art the Christ. But we cannot accept this. For I came at night.
What can I do?
And Jesus began to teach him basics. Just like you have teaching him basics now. I want to know, is this guy serious?
Except a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus, am I not born again? Sir, I am part of the elders of the council. What are you saying?
So okay.
Except a man is born of the water and of the spirit, he cannot enter.
Nicodemus became confused. That was when we now realized that you don't know what they are saying.
Many of you have seen the kingdom, you have not yet entered. The reality of the kingdom is only to them that have entered in. You can see a kingdom power, admire it, you need to come into it functionality.
The man saw the promised land of power, he has not entered.
I can stand here and see the house,
but I have not entered the house. Stand up.
For me to make abundance functionality of what is inside that house, I must enter. If there is a gun in that house and they are killing people here, I can see the gun there. I need to join it there
to lay hold of the gun for me to begin to fire. That is how it works in the kingdom. You can have corner. What they have taught you, you have seen it, but you have not entered. That will require the functionality of the spirit.
When I began to cry, it prepared from casting spells.
Where was spells?
Spirit cast influence upon you.
You don't even know what's going on with you. That guy's what?
Early in the morning, after being prayer, I was called upon. What's wrong? Come now. Don't come now, you just come.
Look at this. What kind of pressure do you want to put me inside? The devil will never put me in emergency. I have prayed before. Calm down.
Wow. You know, just on our own like this. As soon as there's something hit her. Any money. I see fair like that.
So just like last week, the man began to cry. The husband began to cry. I said, what's wrong, sir? He said, actually, as if he went and collected charm from somewhere against his adversary. So now he's feeling as though maybe the people went and collected a higher charm. So they came and struck him. Simple prayer indeed. The man is okay. See, let me tell you. The degree of the potency of the power of darkness is the degree is as powerful to how much you don't know God. I'm telling you, if you don't know God, a charm will be too strong. I've been to places where the charm were alive, they were moving like this. I thought them nothing happened. If you touch them in a wrong man, by a wrong man. Not because of anything, there is a bigger charm inside of me. Yes. It swallowed it.
Yes.
You hear my point? And I was impressed. I heard that even prayer now. For you. I was telling you today, next one should be time soon. 20 hours.
There is time. All this one will say there is no time. There is no time. When we have enough time, that's when we know people that can pray. Not this one that will come around and there's no time. Let generation finish. Let it off. Instrumental. Stop playing. Put it inside. Close the door. Let's pray. No encouragement.
You don't understand. Many of you cannot pray for 1 hour until you put efforts on somebody that is praying. So as the person is praying, you are following in automation. One of my friends was like that. He came to me, he said, he wants to stay with me for a while so that he can learn the way of prayer.
at night. I saw my guy wake up. We carry help is a good. We play prayer. You know most people that even me I have four tiers of prayer, so they put on like people in the room. But that is one, don't even there. After prayer is finished, 1 hour. Yeah, you can. Because I've done 1 hour. So you have not prayed. And then you have not prayed. What did it was for the copy? So there was a day that his phone died. There was no life. It was not the intervention of God. And it was time to pray. He could not pray. He said, please, can I give you my phone that you want to play? He said, are you okay? Come on. When the guy went, he could not bring me. I couldn't even hear his voice. He was just moving. Okay, I had first of all for 10 minutes. Later, there was no encouragement again. I get what I'm saying. And I realized his capacity to play was just 10 minutes. The other ones were just Ojolo, it was malpractice. I have to now sit him down and start teaching again. I said, there is what is called prayer, the word called stature in prayer. Part of the parameters of spiritual growth. Prayer is not one of it, but stature in prayer is one of them. A man that prays, if you give him this microphone, he can shout here for 1 hour. Maybe for 2 hours, for 3 hours, for 4 hours, 5 hours. If he does not have started prayer, he will drop it without we saying drop it. When there is enough time, we know how much can you demand of strength of God. The strength is to understand the quickening ability of the Spirit of God so that you can continue to pray. Mind you, the person that prayed that you are listening to him with an earpiece did not pray with an earpiece. He was praying from the bowels of the rivers that flow that never runs dry. For him, you are tapping from his own grace and you are rising. When will you give expression to the one within you? That is why you will never unlock any reality of yourself. I'm telling you, you chant the chant of men. Those men that chant those chants, you know they were with God and those chants came out. When will you be with God and your chant will? When you see me sing some songs, sing some chant, some days here I get there. As I pray, as I'm just, as you pick the possibility of the Spirit of God, it transcends time. But you don't give it the expression. You remain within an old structure of what somebody gave you and remain there. You listen to men, you copy and paste. What will you do beyond that? Man that has stature, pray. If you like, leave this back up for 100 hours. You continue to pray. The secret is not, it's the purpose in your heart to pray. You talk to the Holy Spirit that quickens you and continue to cry. You must ensure you are saying something. But if you don't know how to pray, very soon you will sit down. The Spirit tell you sit down. When you sit down, close your mouth, you close your mouth. Don't talk, you will not talk. Why? There is no stature. You were praying from your mind, not from your spirit. You do not understand utterance. Unction will never run dry. Utterance is given. The Holy Ghost gives utterance. When utterance connect with the unction, the possibilities are endless. The woman met me and said she talked too much. I said, don't talk too much. You have all trans to talk. So what the things are saying is not rubbish. What they are saying are divine. It's all trans. You come and talk to me for 3 hours. Don't be talking and see. You discover you can't talk for 3 hours. Many of you have all trans to just rubbish just for hours. Others have all trans to speak the mind of God. That was how they sat down and wrote Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Ephesians. It was utterance.
not get what I'm saying?
When you dwell in God, He gives you stature. And when He gives you stature, anything you touch to do, it continually flow. When you want to come here to begin to minister, you may not sing Sinat, you may not sing anyone. You will begin to sing new songs. The Bible says, sing unto the Lord. You will begin to sing new songs. Backed up by the Spirit of God. That will now usher us to a level. When the teaching priest come here, you will begin to open the archives of heaven and begin to cultivate the mind and the heart of God. New things will begin to put upon your heart. Why? A man stand. And whether you leave him here, you can teach for 3 days and Jesus talk for 3 days. No stop. You cannot do that naturally. It needs to be, there must be mastery. It's that job. You believe what I'm saying? In the same way, there are people that have mastered certain gifts and operations. I know a guy that any deaf must open. He may not be too sure of a blind eye. You know, if there are people who the Holy Ghost several times, it becomes so easy. Why? Over time, master you. In the same way, when you continually pray without effort all the time, very soon, you find yourself praying by default. I'm telling you. It's good if you're just praying that happens, but what if in a day where there is no happens? So you cannot pray, you are bad leader. You never had stature for you. It's a ground level ceiling. But you need to reach that level and advance. And prayer will reveal you. But if you are not praying, your life will be a closed book sealed with seven seals. No man can unlock it. Man will see it, you won't enter into it. God will say war with purpose. War. I hear what I'm saying. You will war with it. I can see something now. It will require you to go and jump to come into it. That's it, Charlie. I get what I'm saying. We have that. So bye bye with the prayer group. That is the business of today. You know, sometimes we go for prayer meeting, we say they should carry the clock and go away. If you see anybody with your word, we say we move it, go. Your phone, off it. Now when you pray, when you check it out, you have fallen to the flesh again. Say, this guy is not moving on. What's the problem with that? What is the problem with that? Are you not praying so that you can encounter God? If you can't defend them, no. I get what I'm saying. And even if you have enough time, if you pray, you encounter God now. We increase the time, you pray, you encounter God again. Is it not better you keep encountering God? I will not pray for 7 hours and you don't encounter God and you are going home. You just suffer for 7 hours. Goal is not that you pray for 10 hours, it's that you make the encounter with God. Again, and that's why whether it's the flesh or in the spirit, we try, we carry you, we pray long. But you will cheat yourself. If you do not do that in spirit and truth, and you encounter God. The long hour is supposed to ensure that we stretch all the corn of your flesh and disappear. But only the spirit can be. And that's a man, it's the spirit. There is no reality of the compartmentation of a man that is efficient enough to do business with God. God does not relate to your body, it doesn't relate to your soul. But your soul is your talent. Many of you, your soul is your talent. Your body is your talent. You are sick in your body. You realize that? Your soul is, oh my God, it's damaged. Your soul is corrupted. The purity of your operation of God lies within your spirit.
Your spirit need to colonize your soul, colonize your body. If not, you will be tacky. I'm telling you. I will do the business of today. The prophet is never called to be like a man, he's called to be like a God. What I don't need to understand is that the deed of man is what defines them. Yeah? You are hearing my preaching today. You know you have a sound. You need to hear. Oh, you don't believe. You are singing some of people's songs. Do you know you are supposed to sing your own songs? You don't believe what I'm saying. You read many books. Do you know you're supposed to write a book? Oh, you don't believe. You have come to escort us. Wonderful escort. The possibilities and the deposit of God are life within your spirit. Eh? They are virgins. They have never been with you. Don't wait for a day when I will give you a microphone. No. I have preached without a microphone 1,001 times. And I will continue. I have prayed without a sound. I have prayed without keyboard. You don't need all of those encouragement. I'm telling you the truth. I remember Isaiah 20. When the Lord spoke unto Isaiah, the son of Amos, told him that he should go and lose his sackcloth. He should remove his clothes and walk naked for 3 years. God doesn't talk like that again. How do you want to start explaining to your wife? And God said, I should remove my clothes and walk naked for 3 years for a sign. But that was the Isaiah you put. Isaiah 20, check it this way. Have you not? Have you read it before? Many of you don't need that kind of scripture for you. These are the things that made men, my friends. Most of the instructions of God are terrible, they are heavy. You'll be afraid of them. If you don't have courage and boldness, aided by the Holy Spirit, you may not be there then. Is it Uzziah, right? And she got married possibly. Is it Uzziah? I mean, some of those things you read and wonder, is God, is this one part of the Bible at all? That's how God talks. It's very strange. So the things that you see happening in your life and doing all kinds, and you wonder, where is God in this? He's right there in the midst of you. You know what I'm saying? So let's get to the business of the day. I hope you enjoy my stories. Are you sure? Yes. I'm happy to be here. I love the liberty of spirit. You know, the secret of men is never written. The secret of men is in their stories. There were times when I have to, when I take a sermon of Joanna and I begin to listen to him, one day, what did I say? He told me story, he told that story to us. Oh God, tell me what you are doing. He told me story, he told something. I will sleep in the middle, but I wake up again and continue to watch it. The secret of men is in their stories. I get what I'm saying? Jesus played with children and he shares stories. Gave a lot of values. All of them are part of the kingdom. Let me give you a brief. Today is Sunday, so we should be a brief thing. Okay? Let me see if we can talk about Spirit, give holding over me.
My Holy Ghost is you, Spirit King, burden over me, till I look more like you. Until my Holy Ghost is you, Spirit King, burden over me, till I look more like you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Are you there with me? I said 1 Corinthians 12, right? Let's see if we can give a little bit of definition to spiritual gift. Then we pray. Some people say if they come to church, they don't need Bible, it's not church. So let's read Bible. I went to a place after a minister, a lot of things happened. The camp president came and met me and said, Kai, you didn't quote any scripture. I honor you, but sir, you didn't quote, you didn't tell us the theme and the title of the message. I felt it was really a slap. But it is well, I said no problem. Next time I will. So I told you the title, right? The title is what? Spiritual. And let's read the scripture. 1 Corinthians 12. I'm saying, now concerning spiritual gift, brethren, I will not have the beating of one. They know that you were Gentiles carried away unto wisdom, I don't even as you were there. Wherefore I give you to understand that no man speaking by the Spirit of God calleth Jesus a cause. No man can say Jesus is Lord, but by the Holy Ghost. Now there are diversities of gifts. But the same Spirit. There are differences of administration, but the same Lord. And there are diversity of operation, but the same God which work on. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given unto everyone to profit without. Many of the maybe parts of the scripture you are using with italicized gifts there. How many of you? The word gift there was in Italy. In the Bible. Check it. You know what I mean by Italy?
Hallelujah. Hosanna. Hallelujah. Hosanna. Hallelujah, Hosanna, Hallelujah, Hosanna, Hallelujah, Hosanna, Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Hosanna, Hallelujah, Hosanna, Hallelujah, Hosanna. Hosanna.
You know,
the wind of healing is a super
resurrection. Come upon me. To resurrect anything that is dead. Bring alive again that which has been dead. Dead ability. Dead potentials. Dead passion. That who the devil has told you. I demand a restoration. I demand a restoration. I demand a restoration. The Lord is giving unto you authority. The Lord is giving unto you authority. The Lord is giving unto you authority. This authority will come with a smearing again. With an encroachment of another kind of garment. This garment shall be part of you. A designation. A symbol of the sealing of the Lord. To him who functions in the world of wisdom. The Lord is saying, I am sharpening again your ability to discern within the world. I am sharpening again your ability to discern within the world. And to him that thing he has now, one shall be added unto you. And to him that has one, another shall be added unto you. And you may function in a greater measure. In an increased fullness of population. The Spirit of God will no longer be strange unto you. You will understand. You will comprehend. The Lord is unlocking again the realm of dreams. The realm of prophetic dreams that come with accuracy and precision. And every demonic resistance has been used is taken away. See somebody ask you, how shall this thing be? How shall this thing be? And perceive the Lord has given you an instruction of that which you want to do. You have been wondering, how shall this thing be? The Lord says, my wisdom shall come unto you. My direction and my guidance shall come unto you. Ask no more. I will yet again communicate to you. I will talk to you in a language that you will understand. That you may begin again the plan. Where will I have called you to? In the gift of revelation. When it has been shut down, why? Because of criticism. The Lord of God of heaven. The Lord said that I shall unlock again that bar. Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask that the scorning tongues of men that criticize and shut down the voice of the new promise in the land. They have killed men. They have missed that many. Father, in the name of Jesus, awake again. Arise again in the name of Jesus. It is time for now. We hear a sound. We hear a voice. We hear a sound. We hear a voice. In the voice that we sound. In the sound. A calling decree. The ability to interpret the writings of God. The ability to interpret the writings of God. One walking through a time. anointing your, I am anointing your gifts again. I am anointing your gifts again. That you may minister in the order of the Spirit. That you may minister life. That you may minister life.
He began to give it up to them. And the
God said, what is there of the light of that which has been given unto you? And do not be entangled again in the yoke of God. For in me lies emancipation, in me lies freedom. I shall yet again turn around. I shall yet again change the situation. That which was shall no longer be that which is. Yet again, there is coming a transition. There is coming a shifting. Right now again, not together you are supposed to be, say the Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I saw a people gather for celebration.
Manipulation of demonic energy. Don't come in and attack you by what you.
It may be a natural cause, but it is changed. Grow to your body disappear. Grow to your body disappear.
Demand for you.
for you, shake this burden off. I don't know. I see a conversation. I see a conversation calling God. I see a conversation calling God. I don't know to who. I saw a deed that will be done. Because I see a phone call. I see a phone call in the spirit made from within the shores of Nigeria. And a deed was established. And the establishment of the deed comes with transaction in foreign currency. And I perceive the spirit of God said to someone here, I am making you a global and international people. Whether you're in business or whether you cannot just comprehend, but I see a transaction within the shores of Nigeria for in foreign currency. God said that which I teach unto you, communicate it unto others. I look in between your life. I saw a distortion in the past. I saw a lot of things go out of chaos. Many of them you are not innocent of. But the pastor of the Lord said, my mercy has found you just now. But yet again, you shall be prepared by the speed and the authority of the Lord. A lot of things that is happening in your life because a lot of things that are happening. Which means I believe you will not be innocent. But the pastor of God said, my mercy that has found you, by my mercy I will grant unto you this peace. As I come to your tears, tears fall into my eyes. And the Lord said, the tears of many days will be able to begin away. And to many that mocked you, many that look upon you and insulted you, the Lord said, you will surprise them by your power. I see a growing of your friends. The Lord said, you shall no longer be like unto them. No, you will be an example unto them. You will be an episode even unto them. The Lord said, oh my God, I saw in a vision. The Lord said, they will look into your life and they will say, God is with you. No wonder. No wonder. I didn't get told. I didn't get time by myself. No wonder. I saw you like in episodes. In episodes, you will like them unto others. These ones are meant that you will be put back into the ship.
I will pour your lips to witness unto others. Say the Spirit of the Lord. Apostle Manasseh, whether it's Apostle Aaron, I don't care. But it's a bone condition. Plus your joint, plus your mind. You feel it like you walk for you feel it in our pain. Continual pain. The Lord said that there is an issue within the production of the blood in the mouth. The Lord started correcting that in the name of Jesus. She shall become part of the Greek code. The Lord said, one of you here is going to be connected to a lady named Rachel. God is going to initiate a divine relationship with a lady named Rachel. I see a lady named Rachel. And she is wayward. But I perceive a strong call of God upon her life. And the Spirit of God said, the deliverance of Rachel is connected unto you. And she is found within the campus. The Lord said, I should inform you this, so that when it happens, you will realize that it is the Lord that has sent the person unto you. Says the Spirit of God. I'm giving you strength in your inner man. The ability to be able to handle pressure. I saw you go through a lot of pressure. Having heavy burden upon you. Because I'm giving you the strength and the stamina to handle pressure. And as you handle the pressure, suddenly the will of God will come to you. You cannot say, now after this season of pressure and problem shall come on our life. And I pass the angel of the Lord enter through that direction. Somebody is healing within, let the person come out. Why are you healing? The word of the Lord has moved to this direction. But the challenge is on hands. I told you, you have an option, you know all things. And the word of the Lord came to me. Where is that other guy? I see you leading a youth of people. You are going to be an image to you. I'm going to be an image for it. And the Lord said, I should let you understand that there is a work he has you to do within the youth. The Lord said, he's setting you as a role model unto many youth. And the Lord said, I'm going to give you wisdom on how to capture them. Somehow you don't know why there is an attraction of certain people around in that worship. And the Lord said, because there is an anointing called Anakazu, it's a compelling power. He compelled them unto you. And the Lord said, He has called you unto them that you may be able to equip them aright. Says the Spirit of the Lord. You need to understand that you're going to be involved
in helping you to understand their potential, their abilities in God, and bringing out the possibility in them. If you be like enough to what David did in the cave of Adullam, how many would have been? They were not captured within society. These people were not, they don't belong. But I saw the missionaries of God, the weapons of the Lord within you to help you pick your heart. Your words are going to carry power. When you speak unto them, there's going to come conditions in your life. Said that I'm going to be making you a voice within your school, not just within your academic arena. The strength and the possibility of the Lord living within you, both in sounds and in writing and creativity, is going to be with you. You are going to be an image unto many ladies within your campus, an image of truth, an image of creativity, an image of righteousness, an image of right standing. And the Lord says, let you understand that do not compromise your standards. Many are going to be attracted to you. Many are going to be drawn unto you. But the Lord said, put them aright in the will of the Lord. Many will come to you seeking the counsel of the Lord beyond their own understanding. Small will live beyond your own age. But I heard the Lord said, the wisdom of the ancient is upon you. Maybe you will too. I pass the Lord that the wisdom of the ancient is upon you, and you may be able to cast them aright, don't you go on your now. I don't know whether you are in A school, but I pass the Lord working, you are going to begin to work with certain people that I will be exclusive with you. You'll be finally next year, hopefully, is it true? Okay. I pass the Lord said that within the final year, there is a work that will have you to do within the campus. You will beat men and beat women into intercession to restore a day. The Lord has put a calling upon the campus. I see a lot of things happening within your campus because of lack of consistent prayer. Even among ladies, I swear God said that we come to our lady as a prophet and a voice in intercession within the campus in the Lord. This is bigger than you, boys. We don't according to the grace of the Lord. As I'm speaking to you right now, the angels stand by me saying that there are a lot of encounters and revelations and visitation will be having that perfect understanding. The Lord said, put them within the compass of your campus, and you find that definition. Their functionality, you find the expression within your campus. You ask, how shall this thing be? The singing, the ability. The Lord said, the equipment is for the campus. More for you as he can give. The Lord said you should not be discouraged. The Lord said you should not be discouraged. He said, I will comfort you, I will arise and comfort Zion. The second has come, and now the second time. I don't want to be emotional, I'm trying as much as possible, but you know the thing is this, you must truly really understand the way and the operations of God. The aim of the prophet is consolation, is comfort and edification. I will come back to you. The Lord said I should pick someone. You sang. That was the song I was hearing now.
My help has come. Ebenezer, 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 Ebenezer,
have done it before, how I know. But the Lord began to show me tears and weeping. And the Lord said, I will come again as a believer. It only required that beyond prophecy, beyond a word of encouragement. The Lord said, I will come again as your helper. And I saw the angels of the Lord take again like a handkerchief. And they went again, wiping the holy tears from me. And the Lord told me, He said, there is going to come a sudden change that is sudden turnabout. And to as many that believe and will embrace God as their helper in this season. This will be done beyond prophecy. This will be done beyond word of encouragement. There are certain people that only God can comfort them. Say, blessed be God, the Father of all comfort, who comforts us in our storms, sorrows and tribulations. When would you have been able to comfort others? I will come to your rescue, Jesus. Yes. Yes. You have tried to help yourself, you can't. The Lord here will help you. I'm not doing it. You see, I have no reason to prove to you anything. You have preached a lot of time. The least you can do is to prove something. My reward is in heaven. I will tell you what God is not saying, and you can never put me under pressure. There are a lot of words here. I don't know, we don't have time. I look on your eyes, I think I have your eyes. You. Ah, you watch again. Divine. I don't know, God is interested in you. No one that I think is divine. You are the only person I'm asking what's your name here. As I try to take my eyes out of you, the Lord is pulling my eyes. What's it talking about? You know the meaning of your name? Divine is something that comes from above. You are a daughter of prophecy sent from above. You have no idea of who you are. So God is going to walk with you. From today your life will change. Because I am telling you, you know, as I say it, angels, I work with angels. I have 5 personal angels, I know their names. I have their pictures, they work with me. I have a child, I have a seller that work with me. You will not believe my deed as well. Their responsibility is to ensure that it's done. God is going to begin to grant unto you strange encounters. And these strange encounters so that you can be launched into a highway in the spirit. You begin to hear it differently, see it differently. If you don't have a book to write, now you are going to become. From this night, in the name of Jesus, I curse your spirit to join in the times of God. God is breaking also addictions. Men is struggling all kinds of addictions. God is giving you grace. God will show you mercy in me. The person I want to be killed, the Lord said, I will show you mercy. I just say, I like that in everything you see that you talk. Enough. with the way these angels are talking to us like this now. They say stop teaching. See what I mean?
I read with Romans scripture now. When we want to begin teaching, that's where they started talking. And they see the utterance. If I say I want to expose this now, we will be afraid.
The Lord help you.
Let me see. There is no time. I am a sojourner. Give me 30 minutes. Sit down.
What are 30 minutes? 1 hour.
You are in trouble.
Help me, feed me, feed me, feed me. I need this.
It has come. Holy Spirit.
Let those angels.
But you can't see now. Now be the only one now.
Strength for the journey ahead. I see a lot of things that we don't. And sometimes it's easier to prophesy to strangers and it's hard to prophesy to familiar people. I saw an elevation increase and it didn't really reveal to me. And the Lord said that my grace for you in this season is going to grant unto you strength for the journey ahead. The Lord said, I will give unto you the pen of a ready writer and the tongue of a learner. Where did we stop? 30 minutes? Well, he gave me 1 hour. I don't know how we're going to do it. When we go close now, you are blessed. Alpha.